Het jy geweet, hoe dieper 'n boot in die water is, hoe makliker beweeg hy. Did you know that? The deeper your boat, the deeper your life is in His hands, the easier you can take life challenges and the storms of life. One word from God. He said, Peter, gooi jou net. Hy hoor wat sê. Hy sê, Here, ons het die hele nag hard gewerk. Maar niks gevang nie. Maar op u woord, en ek wil dit verduidelik. Wanneer Petrus sê op u woord, dan bedoel hy nie op dit wat u nou sê nie. Hoor wat doen hy? Hy sê vir die Here, if I fail, you to blame. Don't think it was like people try to explain the scripture. It was like, on your word. You know, I believe. No, no, no. It was not like I believe your word. He says, we've toiled all night. No success. Now you sent me out. If I go this time and I fail, it was your word. It was because of you. That's why the Bible says, as they throw out the nets, to vang hulle so groot vangs, dat Petrus glad die ander gemeentes ook moet roep op hulle boot. You see, that's why it's important. If you want to be effective in ministry, you need partnership. You cannot live in isolation. Ons drie, niemand meer. When true revival comes, you're going to lose the revival. When true revival comes, you're going to miss the boat. When God gave them, when Jesus says, thank you to Peter, the boat was so full that the Bible says they nearly sank. Ever an answer, we say, God is here to give you an overdose. Huh? He wants you to sink in His glory, to sink in His power.
Die pampoen is uitgehaal. As 'n aardappel skil, die aardappel is uitgehaal.
is 'n eie blaar, die eie is uitgaan. Ek is vanmôre hier vir jou te sê, there is acceptance for you.
Amen.
At the table of the Lord. At the table of the Lord. Jy sien, hy gaan weg, gee my. Maar toe hy tot by homself kom, vanoggend wil ek hê you must come to your right mind. Laaslik. Tweede Samuel 9 is 'n storie van hierdie seun. Toe Dawid oorneem, jy moet onthou toe Dawid het lank gewag vir sy autoriteit. Hy was gesalf 17, maar hy moes bykans nog 23 jaar wag voordat hy die troon kon bestyg. Maybe you have received a word from God when you were young, and up till now nothing has come to pass of that word. Maar ek is hier vanoggend om jou te sê, it is a process of God. Dit is die prosesse van God wat jou voorberei, wat jou gereed maak vir die dag wat hy die tafel voorberei. Die Bybel sê Dawid het 'n verbond gesluit met Jonathan. En toe offers neem, when he stepped into his destiny, into his purpose as king. Behalwe dat die eerste ding wat hy gevra het, is waar is die teenwoordigheid van God? Where is the presence of God? Where is the ark of God? Die volgende ding wat hy vra, is daar iemand in die huis van Saul vir wie ek guns kan bewys? Terwille van Jonathan. Ek wil vanmôre vir u sê, God is not doing you a favor because of the covenant. He has prepared a table. It is nothing that you can do that will make you acceptable. It is what has been done 2,000 years ago on Calvary. You see, there's a blood covenant. David vra. Hulle sê, hier is iemand. Die probleem is, ons moet hom met 'n rolstoel insluit. Hy's lam en oud by sy voete. Hoor vir die koning. Hoor vir David. Hierdie seun dink eers o, Here. Hy skree ook, hy vra, hy kan hy skrif gaan lees. Hy sê, "Hoekom roep u vir my wat 'n dooie hond is?" Dis hoe hy na homself kyk. Want hy dink as die koning my roep, dan is die swaard van die dood oor my lewe. Hulle bring hom, hy's bang. Hy sê, "Hoe moet ek?" Want hy dink die koning gaan vir sy lewe vra. Toe hy so instap, sê die koning vir hom, it's not because of what you have done. It's not because of what you has done. It's because of the covenant. It's because of your father, Jonathan. Kyk, dis nie wat jy gedoen het nie, maar wat wel jy gedoen het nie. It's because of the covenant. It's because of the covenant. There's a covenant which I had with your dad. It's not because of you, it's because of him. But there's room at the table.
Oh,
there's acceptance at the table of the Lord. And God wants us to understand. Mense, jy kan nie God omkoop. Jy kan 40 dae vas, 40 dae bid en in sak en as lê. Ons kan nie sy liefde koop. It's done. He paid the full price. Lyk soms so lank. Maar ek wil jou sê aan die ander kant van hierdie tunnel, en ek profeteer vir jou, is daar lig. Maar God wil gaan deurkom. And you will remember this day that there's place at the table. Dis plek by die tafel. Sy wat jou sal uitbring. Wat jou sal help soos hy jou hart help. En ek wil vanmôre ook vir jou sê, want dis wat jy baie keer gevoel het. Maar ek wil vanmôre vir jou sê, alhoewel there's acceptance, my dear. There is acceptance. There's not only acceptance, there's deliverance and liberty and freedom. That's what God is about to do for you. He has accepted you. No matter what you've done, no matter what you went through, there's still acceptance at the table of the Lord. And Here gaan ook vir jou herstel en vir jou heel maak. Ook jou pyn en jou ongelukkigheid. Here kom op vanoggend en hy salf jou met balsam van Gilead. Here raak ook vanoggend jou stikkende hart aan. Raak jou stikkende hart aan.